Got a red current jam out. Okay, so we're gonna reconfigure this for our exploration again. Guess put this here, no, it's the pro pick right there, put the lanterns here. Yeah, so we should be good now. And then we're gonna let these cook as well. Okay, so I'm gonna take half of this meat with me. Just in case. Or, you know what, let's eat the jam now. Get a little bit of that nutrition back. Okay, so that should do for now. And that'll cook, and do I need anything else from here? Bandages topped off. Oh, there's my other bowl. I'll take it back with me when I come back. And I think that's... Oh, wait. Take these. Take this. Okay, I don't need the gears with me. I think that's it. Got everything we need. Or you know what? Yeah, that's it. So, 102. We're good to go. So, we can head back to where we were before, that mountainous area. And it should be daylight by the time we get there. Path has already been lit, so not too worried. And it's actually pretty bright for middle of the night. So we're just gonna follow the lanterns. I'm pretty sure they can improve this. Like, the numbers should not be displayed in the general log. Like, it's just flooding it with these numbers. But it's not too bad for a first pass. Like, this is something that I would probably do if I did something like this. It's just to get something working. Like, it's not ideal. Preferably, if I use it, the numbers should be appearing in front of you. Like, as just a little message, not, like, recorded in the log. Because once you move, that information is just going to be outdated. But at the very least, this thing works. And that's what matters. I'm just saying it could be polished up a lot. So if any of you were worrying that you wouldn't be able to locate the Resonance Archives without access to the world map, well, I hope this alleviated your fears. You can, in fact, get to it just by looking at the numbers. And as you can see, the numbers are going down. If we are getting closer and closer. Now, the problem with this doing it specifically during the winter time is that traversing through this snow is, like, pretty slow. It is kind of painful. But I didn't build any paths here. So, just gonna have to deal with it. The dirt is collapsing, so there's probably something over there that's moving around, causing it to collapse. Okay, so there's lantern that we put down in the previous play session, and there is our progress right there. The lantern's on the other side of the lake. And we burned down this entire area. Nice and clear. I can see if there's any wolves here, and there is not. Now, in previous play sessions, usually around this time, I'm just focusing on building out a stone path network towards traders, just so I can access those traders easier. But since I have something better to do, we're not going to be doing that. It's going to be focusing on the Resonance Archives. And once we complete that, then I'll start looking into building stone paths around the place, because I do like fast movement. And someone commented on the very first part of this series, very recently, that it blows their mind that I'm moving around like an arena FPS player. And for those of you who don't know, I am, in fact, an arena FPS player. Like, I did play Doom and Quake in the 90s. Like, and I didn't just play single player, I also played a lot of deathmatch, a lot of team games, like Team Fortress, the Team Fortress mod, I should say. So I am very familiar with the movements and with the community of those games as well. So that's pretty much why I move like this, is because I'm just so used to it. Like, it is a habit that I don't intend on breaking anytime soon. Now, how did I get back up here? I can just go here. Or you know what? How about... you could probably make it easy on us by doing this. You probably should just not use any spaces there just in case the dirt collapses. Like, I want to leave that intact. Anyway, back to where we were. So, gonna head over there. Now that the fire has dissipated from the peat deposit there, I'm gonna put down the lantern. These are basically my waypoints. Oh, we have to go through here. Oh, I need to eat? Already? I guess you do have to eat more during the winter time. Okay, keep those calories up. And there's that peat deposit that we burned up. And what I want to do... I can't even see it from here. Maybe it would be wiser to push it up over here. Oh, that tree is in the way. I gotta burn that down. This first. Okay, so some peridotite out. Then we'll put the lantern like so. Yeah, there we go. So I can see this lantern from all the way over there from the other lantern. So I've already established that there's like no land over there. I don't want to swim across. So wait, I gotta burn this first. So we're gonna head in that direction over there. Now I gotta warm myself up. How far away are we? So we're still 1754. And make me all toasty. 5, 6, 8. Not going any higher? Okay, 37.8. Good enough, I guess. There was a fire here, so we'll just clean this up just a little bit, if I can. There we go. Okay, let's do wood fence. And there we go. Oh, come on. Am I not hitting these blocks or something? Oh, I guess it's attached to this oak tree, so never mind. Let's clear this brush just so the fire doesn't reach here and destroy my lantern. Like, that should be good enough. Okay, so what am I gonna do? Is, I guess, collapse that. Oh, that's actually convenient. So what I can do is build some ladders here. There we go. So we have access back here. Just in case you're out any flammable stuff. Okay, now we can start a fire. Let's burn through this. Do I want the spell? No. Yeah, so it absolutely should not be touching the ladder. And it looks like this area down here is relatively flat. It's just bushy, so we do need to focus on burning through it. And not burn me, damn it. Just get rid of this brush. I mean, it's 9 out of 9, but nah. Get rid of you guys. Okay, let's get this map back. Oh, fucking hell, polar bear. Or not a polar bear, some other bear. What the fuck do you want? Are you coming over here, you fuck? Yeah, get in the water. So progress is halted because of this bear over here. So let's do a burn around here. See if it comes after me. Okay, I lost eyes on the bear. You know what? I'm gonna run through the fire. Okay, we're clear. Just for good measure. Let's also torch this area. Okay, so bears are active in this area. Gotta watch out for that. I do want to burn around here, just so I can install a lantern. Hey, where do we go from here? So, I'm thinking... through there? Just let me scout ahead first. Just let me see if this is a good path to take. Yeah, it looks like it. We can progress from here. I just want to install lanterns where I've put that fire down. Gonna make sure all this brush is cleared. Okay, I think that's good enough. Get these outer edges as well. Okay, that fire is still going over there. I don't think it'll do that much, though. Alright, 10 a.m. Still got plenty of daylight, but let's not waste it. Oh, I don't like this brush here. Okay, so I can't do this because it's snowing. Just gonna have to manually do it. Oh, wait a minute. Look what I found. Peat deposit. Torch it up. Wait, that's a sheep. We're good. So what I'm doing is just clearing a path this way. Wait, should I be going up here instead? Let's check it out. Okay, so maybe it would be wiser to go through here instead. We're at 1300, but let's burn through this forest here. Now, I want to put a lantern here later on. Just because I do need to mark this location. Okay, we've got some rye grains here. Continue torching this area. You know what? Let's just get rid of the bushes this way. Okay, I want to put down another lantern over here. Okay. Probably should extend this a little bit more. Okay, so it should be safe now. Need to eat. Looks like I need some ladders here. Those are not ladders. Yeah, that's what I thought. So, we don't need ladders anymore. Alright, worked out. Anyway, let's continue making our way over. going to be across this field. Sandstone ruin. I'm not digging that up. How are we going to do this part? Do we go up top or over? Or around, I should say. You know what, we're already going through here, so let's burn it down. Oh, there's some leaky pine. Let's go ahead and get that resin before it burns. And the rift activity is high. And you know what? We should also pick this area just to see, like, what resources are here. Like, this is a dead end anyway. Bitumous coal, borax, chromite, minuscule amounts of native copper, so pretty much no resources to speak of that's worth getting. Like, I already have lots of coal. Like, I have access to lots of black coal and anthracite. And that looks like more resin. Seems counterproductive taking, like, burning down the resin trees, but it's in the path that I need to go through, so I do need to burn it down. Running in this direction, we're not really getting that much closer anymore, and it's going up. Wait, let's check something real quick. 6, 25, 24, 25, yeah. So this tree right here, it's going to be our marker. So we're not going to burn it down, you lucky fool.